Welcome back. In this video, we'll see how to set recognition score threshold. Now the threshold, when do you want a warning? When do you want an error message? And when do you want to make it as pass? So these three things you can put at the back end in the Windows menu bar preferences. You can put a threshold at this place. Now let us understand the logic how the threshold can be put here. So let me give an example. We have already seen this slide, which was there, where I have the OK button object, the properties, values, and the weightage are given. So usually what happens, we have this weightage. If you add all the weightage of properties here in this example, it would be 350. Pause the screen and just calculate, it will become as 350. So 350 multiplied by 100. Now 100 is some unit which we use it by default, RFT has given it. And there's no logical reason behind it, but we use as 100. So 350 into 100, which comes as 35,000, that will be the total weight score. Now total weight score is already given. Now you can just set a recognition threshold that when do you want a warning, at 30,000, 25,000 or 20,000. So you can set a warning threshold. You can also set an error threshold that at 15,000, I want the error message. So that is at the back end. We have a practical for that. So try to understand. I'll combine all the weightages, multiply by 100, and I'll compare with the threshold. It can be warning, pass, or the error message. Now, let us understand the definition, what RFT says. Rational functional tester adds all the recognition scores for a test object recognition properties. Okay, so it will try to compare here and then compares the total to the playback recognition score thresholds. So this is the scenario. So what happens is you will combine the weightage, multiply by 100 and compare with the threshold itself, right? So let us see practically how we work on this set recognition score threshold. Welcome back. Let us see practically how we work on this recognition thresholds. So what is the process I'll be following here is, first I'll record the Classics Java A application. After recording Classics Java A application, I'll execute with the help of B application. Same scripts but with B application. Now when I execute, obviously I'll find out some warnings, some error messages. Then I'll show you why the warnings are received and why the error messages are being received here. Okay, so let us first proceed with the simple recording. Okay, I'll record a new application after this K shared object. I'll click on this record button. L_recognition_thresholds. Click on finish. The process would be same. There's nothing different in recording. So Classics Java A application. Make sure you click on that button, which I would say, for example, if I just open any CD and here in the existing customer, make sure you click on this remember password, because in the B application, this property, this value has changed. Remember the password in B application. So here it is remember password. In Classics B, it is remember the password. So I'll click on this OK button. And after that, I'll properly enter the 16 digits. I'll enter the proper expiration date. Click on place order. Okay, close the application and stop the recording. Make sure you watch this video twice and thrice, because first time it would be difficult to understand. So now after recording it Classic Java application, I'll just show you what is the difference here. Remember the password. Double click on this remember password in the script explorer. Have a look on the properties. The text which we have got it, that is remember password. And here it is given as check remember, which is nothing but the name which is given as check remember. Now in the coming application, in Classics B application, these two properties are different. Okay, how do I know it? Let me show you. I'll just click on this run button. I'll open this Classic B application, click on OK. Now I will try to add one object which is remember the password. Let me show you that. Yeah, see, this remember the password object I want to add in the repository. So you know the process, how do we add in the test object, insert objects, drag and drop it your cursor on this particular remember the password, leave it, click on finish. Now let me show you the change. First I'll close the application. Yeah, let me show you the change. This is the object which I have added right now, that is remember password. Here you can see that is the property which has changed is remember the password. And in the
A application, it is remember password, right? Next is, if I just keep on shuffling between the two objects, have a look on this area and you can easily figure out which other property have changed. The other property which have changed is name property. The name property here, it says remember password. So total two property values have been changed. Okay, what is the weightage of these two properties? One is the 100 and second is 50. So 150 is the total weight of the property values which have changed. 150. 150 multiply by 100. 150 multiply by 100 is how much? 15,000. Okay, so total threshold value here right now is 15,000, which has changed. Okay, now I'll click on this close button. Click on this yes, save this object. Now what will happen? If I go to this window, preferences, and if I go to this place named as functional test, inside functional test, go to playback. In that playback, you select this option as script assurance. Now, what is the thing which is written here? Warn if accepted score is greater than 10,000. That means if the acceptance score is greater than 15,000, give me a warning message. Okay, so 10,000 is the default value. You can see there's a default which is checked out. And now I'll simply click on OK. I'm not making any changes, just showing you what is the value given. Now, instead of classic A, just type as classic B application. Click on run and click on finish. So carefully observe, the execution process will be done properly. There will be no blockage, no stoppage in between. Okay, so here if you see, it is waiting for some time because we have some checkpoint, or you can say as verification timeout, which is 20 seconds by default. So it will wait for some time till it tries to find the object here. So once the object is found, okay, it will do the normal process. It will go for the next step and execute the further steps like card number and the expiration date. Okay, and finally close the application. Once it is closed, I have asked them to show the results in the HTML format. Okay, at the back end I have said as show in the HTML format. Here I have something given as allow blocked contain browser message. I clicked on allow block message, block contain. Here I have got as none failures and verification point none, but I have got something as object recognition is weak. So if I double click on this object recognition weak, here if you observe, object recognition is weak, that means about the warning threshold. You remember what was the warning threshold? That was nothing but given as warning threshold was 10,000. But here it is saying as the recognition score is 15,000. How did it come as 15,000? If you remember, I've explained you, if I double click here, the reason was these two properties have changed. That is name and the text. If you combine this both the property weightage, which becomes as 150 multiplied by 100, that's a standard unit, 15,000, the value comes as 15,000. So if I go back here, it says the captured recognition score is 15,000 and the RFT has been told if the threshold value is 10,000 or above that, throw me a warning message. Okay, so I'm getting a warning message here. These are the properties. If you see, this is the first property, that's a second property, that's a third property and fourth property. These are the different property values which are mentioned into my object repository or the test object map. Okay, so these are few things which you have to take care. Now what I'll do is I will just increase the warning threshold above 15,000, let's say 16,000. Definitely then 15,000 would be lesser than 16,000 and I'll not be getting any warning message. Let us see that practically. I'll go to window, preferences, and here warn if accepted score, I'll just change it to 16,000. Okay, I'll click on apply and click on OK. Now I'll just simply click on this run button, click on finish. Log already exists, overwrite, I'll say as yes. So you can see the execution is going on and same process, it is waiting for the application. waiting for the particular object to find out. So as I said, 20 seconds is the default timeout for the object recognition. So remember, password is one object which has changed, and once the credit card number and the expiration date is entered, right? So I'll just click on this in the result pane, allow blocked contain, and here if you see, the warning is given as none. Okay, that means there's no warning given. So even if you scroll down and find out the option which says as the credit, or you can say the remember password, you'll not find out the any answer for that. That means it has bypassed that stage because of this 15,000. The value which was given was 16,000, so it did not give you any stoppage or a blockage in between. Same way, if I go to preferences here in this place, and now sometimes the you can see the last recognition score that is given as 20,000. That means if the recognition score in the repository, okay, if it is greater than 20,000, RFT will not be able to recognize. That is last chance for recognition score. Here, what I'm trying to say is, if I double click and open this, right? So here, if you observe, there were only two properties. That was 150, 150. Imagine this three properties, 1, 2, and 3. If this three properties have changed, the recognition score is how much? Now it becomes 25,000. Okay. So if 25,000 is the value, okay, RFT will not be able to recognize the object now. Okay, if you go here, preferences, now if because 25,000 is greater than 20,000, then that's the last chance of recognition score. Then you'll be getting not a warning, but you'll be getting an error message that says as object not found. Okay, here it will say as object not found. So what you do is you try to change three property values from here manually, and you see the recognition score, it will cross, and then you'll get an error message at this place. Right now, I'll just make it as use as default, that is 10,000, apply and OK, right? So I hope you have understood how does RFT recognize the object, what are the thresholds for warning, what are the thresholds for recognizing any error, any object and throwing an error message. OK, so these are what you call recognition thresholds. I hope you have understood, and that's all for this video.
Tutorialspoint.com. Simply easy learning.